Hello, Cameron Grimes here, and welcome back to Plumbing TV. In late May, over 150 business leaders from across the plumbing sector supply chain gathered in Sydney for the 2018 Plumbing Supply Forum, an event hosted by Plumbing Connection magazine and the Plumbing Products Industry Group. Attendees were treated to expert speakers covering the economic outlook, BIM, non-conforming plumbing product, industry training, as well as the CEOs of the major regulators that influence the plumbing sector. The issue of lead-free brass also loomed large at the forum. This is an important matter that affects a broad segment of the market, and it appears inevitable that we will see it written into the plumbing code in the early 2020s. Fortunately, there are some lessons to learn from the North American market, which started down the road to lead-free brass implementation some years back. Lead plays an important role in the manufacturing of brassware, and while it is impossible to totally eliminate its use, the move to using a much lower defined amount would appear to appease both suppliers and environmental groups. But it will certainly mean some significant cost increases to brass fittings, taps, valves, and other plumbing items in time to come. You can view all the presentation sessions from the day right here on Plumbing TV's YouTube channel. They call ISH the Disneyland for plumbers, and for very good reason. If you want to see the world's largest display of the latest technology in plumbing equipment, pipes and fittings, bathroom product, instrumentation and HVAC equipment, then ISH in Frankfurt, Germany is the place to be. And this enormous biennial event is on again in 2019. You'll share the aisles with 200,000 other trade visitors viewing 2,500 display stands, but in typical German efficiency, it's all very orderly. ISH 2019 will run from Monday, March the 11th through to Friday, March the 19th. That means you can get over and back in a week, spend 3 days at the exhibition and even a lay day or two, taking in some of that beautiful close-by German countryside and history. Now is a great time to take advantage of cheap airfares, but more importantly is the issue of accommodation. It's ridiculously expensive at most hotels within Frankfurt, so consider Airbnb or stay at one of the satellite towns close to the railway, as the excellent train service drops you off underneath the exhibition halls. ISH is an experience you'll always remember. Two of Australia's plumbing industry success stories have recently announced major billion-dollar investments in the international plumbing market. In early May, Reece acquired a leading plumbing product distributor in the US market. The company is called MORSCO, and in terms of industry rankings, MORSCO operates the 10th largest plumbing supply business in North America, with a store footprint of 171 branches across 16 states in the fast-growing Sunbelt region. While it's not as large as Reece's existing operations across Australia and New Zealand, it is nonetheless a strong beachhead into the North American market. Also announced in late May was the acquisition by Reliance Worldwide of John Guest, a major supplier of pipe fittings in the UK market. John Guest also has a less significant presence in Australia. Reliance has shown an appetite for a push-to-connect pipe system previously in the Australian and US market, where it has achieved market leadership with its SharkBite brand. It is now clearly a global leader in that technology. The Reliance name is not totally new to Europe, as it has developed significant valve business across Europe over many years. The company expects to achieve some synergies with this latest purchase. The Australian stock market has responded well to both these acquisitions, with solid performing industrial stocks currently being valued by analysts and investors alike. Well, that's it for another month of Plumbing TV. Be sure to keep up with all the latest happenings in the plumbing industry through our Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn accounts. I'll see you next time.